It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Unknown gunmen investigate activities of DSS in Southeast now. Uriwa tells governors. The news in full. The Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria, Uriwa, has called on the Southeastern governors to investigate the activities of the Department of State Services, DSS, in the region over the alleged killing of residents. The rights group stated this while reacting to reports making the rounds that a DSS operative was gunned down by a police officer who was confronting unknown gunmen in Imo State on Tuesday. According to Uriwa, the report indicated that the Nigerian Secret Police may be part of the unknown gunmen wreaking havoc in the region. The Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria, which faulted the recent decision of the Southeast governors to clamp down on any member of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, who is found enforcing the sit-at-home order in the region, regretted that Igbo political leaders are chasing shadows and failing to take deep measures to check the expanding frontiers of coordinated attacks against residents of Southeast of Nigeria. According to a statement issued and forwarded to Daily Post on Tuesday by its coordinator, Comrade Emmanuel Omobiku, Uriwa recommended that only pragmatic measures are required to bring an end to the rising security challenges currently ravaging the entire region and underparts of the country. The statement reads in part, Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria is once more compelled to express resounding disappointment and shock at the clear absence of any pragmatic approaches by Igbo leaders and governors but instead most of the decisions reached on Tuesday in Enugu are cosmetic, unrealistic and utopian, wishing that there should be an end to sit-at-home order which has been violently enforced in spite of the denial of responsibility for issuing the order by the proscribed Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB. This shows that these so-called political, religious and cultural leaders are living in the world of utopia. The most pragmatic approach is to negotiate an end to the tagging of Indigenous People of Biafra, that is IPOB, as a terrorist group, instituting of constructive back-channel dialogues with the detained leader of IPOB, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and its members, consider conditional release for the incarceration of all prisoners of conscience belonging to the IPOB, including their leader, and for government to realistically investigate the possibility that Mietiala may have a hand in the activities of the so-called unknown gunmen. The Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria actually said that Nigeria has continued to meander the path befitting failed, weak and juvenile states, a state that had very great prospects. They averred that it was disturbing to note that while Nigeria is the third most terrorized country in the world, next to Afghanistan and Iraq, the Buhari-led government actions are centered on cows in such a way that cows are more secure in Nigeria than Nigerians, just as the elders are armed to the teeth to the knowledge of government authorities. Also, the Human Rights Writers Association revealed that Nigeria's public debt stock, which has reached $84 billion, with debt service costs gulping about 80% of entire government revenue. Nigeria's external debt increased by 107.4% from $12.6 billion in 2015 to $27.4 billion by the end of 2019. Furthermore, the rights group expressed worries that between March and June 2020, a total of $10.26 billion new debt was approved by the National Assembly, while other approvals for more loans were also given this 2021. Of the four administrations who have led Nigeria since our return to democracy in 1999, the current administration holds the worst records in terms of economic growth. Olusegun Obasanjo regime from 1999 to 2007
has had an average growth of 6.9%. His immediate successor, Umaru Yar'Adua, did even better in his 2 years with an average growth rate of 7.6%, while Goodluck Jonathan delivered 5% growth rate in his 6-year term as president that ended in 2015, the group added. Relatedly, Human Rights Writers Association also used the occasion of the 61st Independence Celebration of Nigeria to call for cessation of conflicts and attacks in the southeast of Nigeria so dialogue can be embraced. The Human Rights Writers Association further called on indigenous people of Biafra to strictly enforce the suspension of the Monday Sit At Home order, as well as the United Nations for intervention and the release of Kanu. And these were the words of the Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria, that the Independence Day celebration was just a charade and that the Buhari-led administration needs to release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, where they say that the country is actually failed already, and the ineptitude, incompetence and insensitive high-handedness, and also the nepotism by the Buhari-led administration of the country has led us all into disaster and woes. The group also said that that good governance has actually been abandoned, and that Nigerians are now suffering from conflict and terrorism in the country, saying that President Muhammadu Buhari is actually falling into this kind of mess because of the kind of people he surrounded himself with, such as Garba Shehu, who is the special, presidential aide, and also that all the other people who are just not telling President Muhammadu Buhari the truth just because of their selfish and pedestrian interests. The Human Rights Writers Association also challenged President Muhammadu Buhari to initiate concrete, genuine and deep national reconciliation and dialogue, and not to go after people that are clamoring for their right to self-determination. In a statement signed by National Coordinator Comrade Emmanuel Onwobiko, Human Rights Writers Association carpeted the nation's political class for their alleged collective and classical lack of leadership acumen. The experience of Nigerians since 2015 has actually been impressive. And before then, Nigeria was the third fastest growing economy in the world, next to China and India, with a growth rate of close to 7%. But the economy contracted immediately after swearing in of President Muhammadu Buhari took more than 6 months to constitute his cabinet. Therefore, the Human Rights Writers of Nigeria had actually said that Nigeria, the state of Nigeria now is disturbing because it is now the third most terrorized country in the world, next to Afghanistan and Iraq, and that the only thing that the Buhari-led administration is doing is centered on chaos, and that Nigerians, just as elders, are armed to the teeth to the knowledge of the government authorities, and that the past government had actually recorded a good growth in the economy than the present President Muhammadu Buhari's regime, saying that there is need for the indigenous people of IPOB to continue with the agitations to secure the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Thanks for listening.